Hi there. Yes, this is a let's play I started 4 years ago. Yes, I am continuing it after a 3 year gap. No, I haven't gone completely insane. Not yet, anyway. Nah, cutscenes. Who needs cutscenes? We already know what happens.
What is this? Wow, what a mansion!
Captain Wesker, where's Chris?
If I'm controlling him, probably like lying down on the floor
Stop it!
unconscious with
Don't
zombies
open that
chewing on him.
door!
But Chris is.
What is it?
Maybe it's Chris. Now, Jill, can you go?
I'm going with you. Chris is our old partner, you know.
Okay, let me handle this. Stay alert.
Don't worry, I will. Yes, this is completely uncalled for. No one asked for this. Let me just tell you that no one asked for this to happen. This is something I want to do. Maybe because I have such a bad taste for this game.
A dining room.
Jill is much easier to play this game with. So much easier. And I was going to do her side of the story at some point. I just put it off so much. That's no different. And, how blind is this?
What? What is this?
What is it?
Blood. Jill, see if you can find any other clues. I'll be examining this. Hope this is not Chris's blood.
So many quotable lines. Yeah, it's not completely blind, honestly. Like, I've had a few things spoiled for me. How can you not know about this kind of shit? The dialogue's so awful and But I don't know much about what actually happens in terms of really, Jill, you're gonna actually tell me that. Can I take the emblem? Oh, I can. I can take it this early and look how much inventory space I have. It's amazing. Yeah, Chris only has 6 slots all the way through the game. I thought that might have changed, or at least if I played the second game and third game first, I would have assumed that he would have picked up an item which enhanced his inventory. That never happens. And he starts off with a fucking knife. You can actually go back through this door, from what I know, even though obviously you're not supposed to go this way, and this happens.
Investigate if you hear any gunfire.
Well, that sounds weird. Actually, only came through my right earphone there, I think. And his voice sounds different. It's Mr. Whiskers. Whiskers. Captain Whiskers. But yeah, you can actually do it again! Wait, maybe not.
Lost courage already?
Yes.
It's not like you.
It's not. I beg to differ. What happens if I do it again? Oh, okay. There may be more here worth investigating, but yeah. I don't know if that's an Easter egg or not. Like, can it be classed as an Easter egg just going back like that? I don't know, but there is a few things. Oh my god, the controls are so different to Resident Evil 3 and stuff. I was originally gonna do this before I did Resident Evil 3, but something happened which prevented me, so
Who is it?
Huh?
Hey, you! Stop! Run, Jill! He's insane!
He's insane? Hey, he literally came walking towards Jill and he's put like 2 Magnum bullets in his head or
What
something
the
like that.
hell?
Let's
Completely
report
blown it
Mr.
off.
Wesker.
It's not funny, mate. But yeah. That I don't remember that happening before. Maybe I've completely confused the game by going back through that door so much. Is Barry actually? Oh my gosh, I didn't know that this was possible in this game. He is actually following me. Can I still go into the other room, or will it now not allow me to? But yeah, you're supposed to go through to this room. Yeah, I've got to report this to Wesker. I can't go through there now. That's so odd. Okay, I'm discovering new things already, but yeah, you're supposed to go through into that room. You do the investigation. That zombie stands up, attacks you. Technically, I've saved myself some bullets here in a way. Oh god, I'm gonna going around the entire buttons, just pressing them all, trying to figure out what does what. Yeah, let's go back to Whiskers, shall we?
Wesker! Help me look for him, Jill. And don't leave this hall for the time being.
I'll be a good girl. Okay, what happens if I try to? I'm just going to try and break this game as much as possible now. I've got to search this hall first. God, so bossy. Right, there's ink ribbons on this table here. I don't really think I need them this early on, but they're for saving and shit, as you probably know. I'm talking like you've never seen me play this game before. I really should be assuming that you watched the previous part first. Yeah, I know. I'm actually looking around the doors and shit. But I really hope you haven't, because that Let's Play is so fucking awful. The first segment of this is so bad. I wish I could just redo everything, but...
Find anything, Jill?
Nothing. What is this all about? I can't figure it out at all.
Beats me, too.
Now it's Wesker's time to disappear. I don't know what's going on.
Well, it can't be helped. Let's search for him separately. I'll check the dining room again.
Okay, I'll try the door on the opposite side.
This mansion is gigantic. We could get into trouble if we get lost. We should start from the first floor, okay? And, Jill, here's a lockpick. It might be handy if you, the master of unlocking, take it with you.
Thanks. Maybe I'll need it.
Listen, if something happens, let's meet up in this hall. This time, I'll be there.
I'm trying desperately not to do the usual Let's Play a mic-take of all the bad lines in this. I'll just ignore them. I'll be different. I will be different. There we go. I'm gonna go in there because, there's a few items I missed back there due to everything that happened, really. No quick turn in this game as well. But yeah, I thought this would be kind of interesting as well because, it gives me a bit of time to talk. The music's changed. Wait, I thought the game had frozen then, and I think my mouse... Sorry, I'm emulating this, and I don't know if it's obvious because of how non-pixelated Jill is, and I try not to make it look too weird. I hope it's acceptable, but, I think my mouse just hovered off there and, deselected the game or something because it froze. No zombie here? Oh my god. Forrest, what happened to you? No, that's not Forrest, that's Kenneth. Kenneth from the Stars Bravo team. Yeah, he's been eaten a bit. He has actually been eaten by the zombie. Oh my god, he hasn't got bullets on him as well. Maybe it is more different than I thought it was, but I assume that, Jill's side of the story and Chris's were quite similar, not like Resident Evil 2 where there's a stark difference between the two. Especially if you do the A scenario then the B scenario, then it changes pretty much everything. But yeah, sorry. I thought this would be interesting because, oh my god. Yeah, another advantage of being Jill, you can just randomly unlock things, whereas Chris, you have to collect a load of fucking keys. The HD version of the remaster game, I know this is a bit of a mindfuck if you've never heard of it before. The remastered game, let me take you back, GameCube, 2002 I think it was, maybe a bit later than that, probably a bit later than that. Looks pushable. I don't remember doing any of this shit, by the way. Maybe push it the other way then. Yeah, there was a remake of this game. This is from 1996. Ah, there we go, music sheet. Music notes, of course, because this game is very English. Yeah. There was a, check the piano, I don't know, I think Jill can actually play the piano, whereas Chris requires Rebecca. Too much is going on for me to actually bloody talk. It's the Moonlight Sonata. Go on then. Yeah, I'm gonna whiz through this. I'm actually gonna fucking fly through this game, I bet. It's gonna be a time challenge more than anything else. So, like, in Chris's side of the game, I came into here about an hour and a half after play, I think. And this is like 10 minutes in? We're 10 minutes in, yes. But what the fuck does this do? It opens there, and there, from what I recall, I already have the emblem, so I can just take this one. But the thing is if you take this gold emblem, The door now closes behind us, so all we have to do, like I did in my previous bit with Chris, is shove in the fake emblem that we picked up earlier. So yeah, GameCube, 2000 and something, early 00s essentially, maybe mid, I don't know, but probably better to say mid. A remake of this game. It is really nice because it allowed Capcom to take the next gen sort of quality and use, you know, the whole static kind of method of use of Resident Evil and actually make it more detailed, because obviously you've got set backgrounds. It's only the fixed camera angles, isn't it, that's going on. So it just allowed them to make it so much more prettier. But yeah, that has been remastered. Oh my god, I hate remasters, but apparently been remastered, and for next gen, again, bloody quotation marks, it's probably really shit. Overall, it's not going to be anything like Halo 2, for example, but I really want to play it, because it looks like a really good game. There we go, we got Mansion Key already. So I get the feeling I'm not supposed to... Where the fuck did Barry go, actually? He said he was going to be in this room, didn't he? What's this one? It's a shield key. I never knew you could do this in the, my Chris playthrough, actually. But yeah, the, you can see a picture on the back of the key. I just always click the description and it would tell you what it is, but now it is the shield key. There we go. So, but yeah, I'd really like to play that on release. And I've received a few donations off people, so I might just throw money into it, get the Steam edition. So I don't have an Xbox One, don't have a PS4, but I do have an Xbox 360. But do I really want to play it on Xbox 360 when it's probably not designed for it? You see what I'm playing at here? Maybe you want to go for the Steam edition, but I bet it'll be shit because Capcom is terrible with PC ports. Carving an armor, so we can't get through there because that's... not what we're after carving of a shield, I guess, but she'll just automatically shove the key in the lock anyway, and hey ho, open door. Right, so, oh my god, this is so nice, actually. I've emulated this quite well. I mean, you can go a bit too far with emulators, but this has come out really nicely, hasn't it? So yeah, map on the top of the statue. We'll just shove this over here and voila, up we go. Grab that. I feel like I'm just doing a playthrough, not a bloody blindless play. It's going to be far too similar, I bet. But oh well. It's worth a go. I just wanted to find out what happened to Jill before the Resident Evil 3 events. People told me I actually played, you know, I should have gone with Jill as opposed to playing Chris. Dead zombie. No, dead zombie. Really? I mean, just lying zombie, I guess. Oh, came all this way for ink ribbons? No, fuck off. Yeah, that was a bit silly, really. Never mind. But, you have to be careful with these guys, because, as you saw in the, in any of the games I played, like, the lime ones, they tend to be the most dangerous. They just grab onto your foot, start chomping away. An ouchie. Pain. Lockpick. Again. The many uses of the lockpick. So, this room. Possibly my least favourite. I'm just wondering if I should just run straight through here, or... We already know what happens. I mean, if you watch my Chris playthrough, maybe you just completely ignored it, but... I don't mind if you've ignored it, because it is fucking awful, as I said. Can I possibly... No. You can push these, you see, or some of them, but I think it's more obvious which ones you can push. So let's just run this, shall we? Oh no, dogs. So not expecting there. And again. Whoa, shit, that one almost stopped me there. So there we go. Now, the only problem is I just need to never go through there again. Oh my god, that is terrifying. Oh. Oh, she doesn't look that bad at that angle. It's quite detailed, actually. Like... Yeah, she doesn't look that bad now. I mean, I played around with the settings and stuff, and that actually looks really nice. I'm used to, like, shoving everything in pixels and stuff, but never mind. Right, first green herb, thank you very much. Sorry. Too much attention to the detail, really, aren't I? I can't remember much of where I'm supposed to be going and stuff, really. I mean, imagine this is different anyway. Carving of armor, again. There's two armor doors we found. Did they show up on the map as different colors? No, it's file. Try again. I can't remember how to shoot in this game. That'd be a good start. Right, no, they don't show up in different colours like in Resident Evil 2. That's a bit shit. Never mind. Not a problem. We can work around that. I have no bullets, do I? I'm used to, like, getting the bullets off Kenneth. Well, actually, Chris doesn't really get... He doesn't get a gun for the first, it's the mirror. I remember the mirror. He doesn't get the gun until, like, he goes back into the room, so he has to fight the first zombie with the knife. Or he doesn't have to, I learned. He can just turn around and run. And then come back later when you've got the gun. Is there anything in here? I guess not. Wow, my memory's worse than I thought it was. I don't even remember this room thinking about it. I remember talking about Saw in this room for some reason. Oh, and I remember talking to myself in the mirror as well. Jeez, so long ago. So quiet as well. A bit worried. Half expecting the hunter to come in here. Right, let's try this room anyway. Oh. I do remember this graphical glitch. That's why... Yeah, I don't remember if it comes through in the video or not, but I do remember there is... This is the only part of the game that there was ever a graphical glitch when I first emulated it. It's like flickering here. I don't know why it happens, but that's a better camera angle. We really don't want that horrible camera angle when we first came in. I assume you guys see it, or at least I hope you do, because, of course, like, you should be seeing what I'm seeing. But I do remember it being removed from the original video. Tapestry, nothing useful. I don't know, maybe you could, like, wrap a zombie in it, kick him downstairs or something. Hello, baby. An urn with beautiful picture on it. Nothing unusual. Not for a creepy old mansion, I guess. Right. Come into my hands, please. So, we've already got the shotgun. Without even firing a shot at the pistol. And oh no, something dodgy has happened there. Now, we come here a lot later with Chris, or we came here a lot later with Chris, so what's going to happen here? I already know, unfortunately, but... Oh no, what am I going to do? I know, I'll run around this room in circles. Maybe check the door once, twice, I don't know. Let's give that a go. Okay, check the room that we... No, it's locked. Oh no. Even this lockpick that I'm the master of a locking with... is completely useless in this scenario. What will save me? I will rotate on the spot. It's quite fitting
hey,
to the music, actually.
What's going on?
Well, I can tell you that you're about to be crushed to
Jill?
Death.
Is that you, Jill? What happened?
Barry? Help me, please. The door won't open. Quick!
Stay away from the door, Jill. I'm gonna kick this door down.
Hurry!
Hey, Barry, this just chilling. I'll take my time. Oh, I never saw the running animation through the, door.
Oh, Barry!
That was too close. You were almost a Jill sandwich.
You're right. Barry, thanks for saving my life.
Resisting urge to make fun of game.
But Barry, didn't you say you're going back to the dining room to do some research? Why on earth are you here?
Yeah, you dick.
I just had something I wanted to check. Now, let's get back to searching for the lost captain and Chris, shall we?
Guys, you can see the grays in his beard. Oh my god.
Thank you, Barry.
Yeah, yeah.
I never even knew there was gray in his beard. You can actually see the models. That's amazing. Right, okay, so. We got out of there. We acquired a shotgun. So. Did he just say he's going back to the... No, he didn't say he was going back to the dining room. So nothing of that nature. Where does the shield key go then? But anyway, we're going to go this way because can't see much else we can do. Oh, right, first zombie, finally. I wonder when you were going to come along. So if you take these down, they're pretty much dead already. I'm going to do the Resident Evil 2 thing here. Just double tap, you know. Make sure they're dead. And here's another, actually. Maybe we can avoid this one if we go through this door here. Yeah, I unlocked it, right. Maybe there's not much point in avoiding that zombie. Maybe we're gonna have to go through that way. I don't know. Find out, eventually. Gonna avoid using first aid sprays in this game, because, I think it does decrease the ranking. Let's see if we can get a nice rank with this game, like I was gonna try and do with, Resident Evil 3. Oh, shit. No, that didn't go very well. Oh! Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! 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 He actually just took a right chunk out of me. Why wasn't I able to push him off? Was I pressing the wrong button or something? Like, Jill literally just stood there while he chomped on him. Her. It. I don't know. Whatever gender she is now. Either way, let's hop in here. Key item here. This is what we got before with Earth on it for some reason. Chemical, right. So we'll drop off a few items. Oh my god. I actually have clips in my inventory. This game is just taking the piss. Can I combine these, perchance? That'd be handy. Yeah. No. No. Okay. Well, I'll see if I can bind them in the actual inventory itself, you know. Yeah, let's try that combine. Yeah, that works, okay. And the inventory literally just rearranged itself, pretty much. Shotgun. I don't think I need it at the moment, but... looking at my health's going already. I don't know, maybe I should keep it on me. I'll drop off the, clip for now. Chemical? It's pretty much on the other side of the mansion that I need that from what I recall, so I think I'm going to drop that off because I think there's going to be opportunity to actually pick that up again and use it at some point. So let's hop out of here. I'm not going to waste too long in this place. I do really need to remember to save at some point after probably half an hour of play at least or something like that. I don't know. So should we go upstairs or should we go down this corridor that was next to us? Where am I? I'm not entirely sure which area I'm in at the moment. Oh, god, this is... Oh, sorry, the red one over there. Sorry. I'm blind. There's a door next door, and there's all... there's a room next door, even, and then there is also an outdoor passage that leads to the next area, from what I recall, that requires certain items to get to. Let's check the room next door first. There is a zombie in the way, but we can source him out easily enough. Probably avoid him completely, maybe. Don't know. I don't think they change position like in the... Oh, it's locked. Okay. Carving of a helmet. Wait, where's he gone? Oh, he's there. Right. Hey, I don't remember this door. Is this the one that leads outside? No, it isn't. What? I am getting so confused right now. I thought this was the area that leads outside. Oh no, there was another door. Right. And there's this puzzle here. Oh god, that actually frightened me. That's quite loud. Can we turn this down a bit? Tiny bit. Be careful because my volume is so sensitive because I have to run this at maximum volume. But you remember this puzzle, I hope. Yeah, pretty much just got to repeat exactly the same thing. It's give me the peace of death and I'll give you the joy of life. There's a switch below where you... No, we don't want to push that yet. We need to, the piece of... What? Is that the same as before, or am I getting confused now? The piece of death and... I thought we had to arrange it by age of... the age, you know, like from... something to grave. That's what it said originally, from what I recall. I need to be careful. I'm not killing myself with this thing. Yeah, if you fuck the puzzle up, from what I recall. No, here we go. Give me peaceful sleep. What? That's so vague. I thought it was something else. I swear it was like... from cradle to grave or something like that.
Oh, this is the crow room. The picture is entitled, From Cradle to Grave.
I could have sworn it was, but anyway, let's try doing that instead. So here we go. Let's try not to piss off the crows. So that looks like the youngest newborn baby. Young man, maybe not that. I think child would come first or something. Infant. What? It's infant... lively boy. Infant lively boy. That would make sense. There was newborn baby, okay, right. So we need to go back to infant, then child, then maybe young man. What was on the other side? Let's try that. Infant. Lively boy. Watch me do this all wrong. It's by assumption that it's exactly the same as before. I think my memory is worse than it used to be. Tired middle-aged man. I think that's not the next one. I can't remember, is it? The young man one here? Yeah. Yes. Then... this one, I'm assuming. Please, please be right. If not, I'm just gonna have to charge straight out of here. Probably give up on this game already. And then the last one is gonna be this, isn't it? Did I miss one? I hope not. Okay, here goes. It worked, I think. It did, yeah. Cool. So I did do it right after all. But there we go, I've already got one of the key items that you need, the Star Crest. A bit early, but hey-ho. I should have really done this before going to the next area. Doesn't matter, you can do it in any order, it's just, it would just have been more convenient, if you get what I'm saying. So I'll go plant that in the inventory and keep moving, I guess. Zombie there. Nearly ran into him there. Just not used to the controls. They're really tanky in this in comparison to the third game. Bit more floatier in that. It's nice. I wish they were always like that. I think I've turned this a bit too quiet now. Watch me, I'll get a tiniest little bit of volume. There we go. That's too loud again. Fucking hell. Right. There we go, that's alright. I'll just leave it that way. Right. So, we'll drop off the crest. And, technically we could pick up the chemical, but it'll be alright. Got plenty of things to pick up, I think. So, we'll march upstairs. Might as well do. I mean, we've not been upstairs yet, have we? And then, have a bit of scouts around there. The stairs look bloody nice. They look real. What the fuck is going on with this game? Right. So, here's a bit of a nasty place, really, because, zombie here, and I think there's a zombie behind me as well. But, oh god! Did he just vomit on me? He did as well. He actually got a chance to vomit on me before he died, even though his head was falling off. That's nice. So that's locked, carving of armor. Like we already knew that anyway. Oh, this is open. I don't remember much being in here, if anything. I'm on caution, aren't I? I need to be careful. Right, more green herbs. Lots of green herbs. We could use a green herb. No harm in that. There we go, we're back to fine. Great. That's... I'm not sure if that's supposed to be blindingly white coloured. Wood to put in the stove, a paper on the wall. Maybe it is, after all, I don't know. But this door is locked, yes. Thought as much. Helmet again. Right, so we got two helmet doors and two armor doors, and yet we have no shield door. I wonder where the shield door goes then. Right, need to be careful down this corridor because... oh, he's round the corner. How close is he? Depth perception isn't great in this game, so that's two shotgun shells we used there. And this door's broken from one side, so we need to loop around, basically. But it's open from the other side. From what I recall, anyway. And now we're in a corridor with a zombie. We'll kill him via a pistol. Since he's some distance away. Come on, I know you're not dead. Don't play those games with me. Oh god, okay. Funny. Hilarious. Right. Oh, you put it back on caution. That's not very nice. So yeah, we can loop around again. God, that actually made me jump. I should have moved away, really. Should have moved away. Nothing uncommon. They say such weird shit in their English. It's well arranged, yes. It's well arranged. And anything in here? Nothing uncommon again. Nothing uncommon apart from that boot that's just standing out there. There is no point in me getting this. It's basically an explanation of the herbs. So, Botany Book, get in my inventory, thank you very much. Though, that's a good point. I never read anything in the original Resident Evil playthrough, did I? Because the first time I started reading things properly was actually in Resident Evil 2. thinking about it. Like, it was the only Let's Play I didn't read things in, so maybe when we get a more interesting book, it's not about herbs, I'll have a read of it properly, you know. No, we'll take a time with this, because it's going to be a pretty fast-paced Let's Play, isn't it? It's locked. Carving of armor again, so that's three doors with armor. Zombie down this corridor. Let's take him out with a pistol. Got enough bullets, I think. Oh no, maybe not now. Watch. I bet I'll have to finish him with a shotgun blast or something like that. Let's try to get behind him. No, really? Jill, come on, aim at him. Wait, I think he's dead, actually. Right, okay, now I've wasted all the bullets in that. That's locked. Carving of armor. So that's four doors with carving of armor. So, we've pretty much done a full circuit here, I think. Let's have a look at the map. Yes, we have. This is leading back to the main area where we first came in.
Barry!
Jill, what's going on? Any clues?
No, but something's wrong with this house.
Whoa! This hall is dangerous! Maybe it's better to secure our escape route first. There must be a back door somewhere. Let's try to find it first, shall we?
Oh my god.
Okay, let's separate again.
Just a moment. I found something.
What is it?
They sound slurred as hell.
It's a weapon. It's really powerful, especially against living things. Better take it with you.
But how about you, Barry?
I have this.
Thank you. I'll take this then.
Right. So here's something I missed out in this game, really. Bloody grenade rounds and grenade launcher. We don't actually have the grenade launcher yet. But we'll acquire that in just a moment, from what I remember. Okay, so Barry's buggering off again. Yeah, they sound high as hell. Like, if there is a game, a Resident Evil game, that they are just on equip the shotgun, and if there is a Resident Evil game where they actually, decided to smoke the herbs instead of, you know, whatever they do with them. What do they do with them? Never thought about that. This is definitely the game that they smoked it all in. It's not as bloody, this corridor. Am I playing the censored version of this game or something? I remember it being completely caked in blood in the Chris, in my original playthrough. Maybe I'm playing, yeah. No, I'm definitely playing the original version of the game, because one of the problems I had with my original Let's Play was getting the director's cut, which was god-awful. So it's nice to hear the original soundtrack and everything, instead of the horrible director's cut one. Right, so, grenade launch is here. There we go. So now we're going to blow up the crows. No, I'm just kidding. sorry. Throat's getting a bit funny. Do we actually have acid rounds in it, or do we have bazooka rounds, or what? It's not obvious, is it? Let's see. Check. Explosive rounds loaded. So, what? Can I actually not take these out? How do I... I can't. I actually cannot take them out. I need to fire them in order to use the next set. That is a bit shit. That is a bit dysfunctional. In the other games, of course, you can just load any in it or remove the other round. I don't even know the point in doing this, but, that's Forrest. He's the one who's been pecked to death. My god, I can see him in detail. It's clear they just put the textures on top of the, actually, no, they've done a better job, to be honest. It actually looks like there's a bit of depth going into his skin, you know, beyond his clothes and stuff. It's not like bloody Alone in the Dark, 4, where they... Well, that game came out in, like, 2009, it looks like they just shoved the textures on top of the clothes. But yeah, he's been pecked to death by crows. Oh no, the crows are right here coming after me, and I can't do a quick turn, so I'm gonna have to run like this instead. But yeah, that... no problem. No issue at all. So, I don't have a clue what the hell this bazooka's for. I love the bazooka so much. A grenade launch, more like, but... Bazooka's such a better name, I should use it more often. Bazooka. Bazooka. Who invented this word? It sounds so sexy, doesn't it? Bazooka. I'm getting off at a right tangent here today. But yeah, I have no idea what I'm supposed to be using this for at all. I'm guessing it will come in handy at some point. So let's actually go back into the dining room kind of area, I guess. I really need a safe room. There is one somewhere around here. There's a zombie here. Let's see if I can just snap him out with one shell. There we go. He's going to come grope me. And from what I recall, there's one on the other side of this, isn't there? Somewhere. There we go. Yeah, there he is. If I can get him close enough. Actually position the statue between me and him, make it easier to kill. Oh, it stopped. Okay, there we go. Now his body's despawned. But I'm going to need to go back downstairs anyway, which is going to be a pain in the ass, but oh well. Because I need to push this over here, get the gem out of it, and to do that, I need to go downstairs and grab it. I'm sorry if this playthrough is being a bit, sort of, you know, half-assed, a bit wispy in comparison to my other stuff, but like I said, this is pretty similar to the other side of it. Hopefully it changes at some point, but if it doesn't still, either way, I'm going to have fun finding out what the actual story is behind this, beyond what I already know, which is pretty much up to this point, actually. I really need a drink. My throat is dying. Right. Yeah, we're all out of inventory space already, aren't we? There's nothing inside. What? There's nothing inside what? You can clearly see there's a bloody gem on the floor there. Right, thank you. I thought she wasn't going to take it then. So, yeah, I need to get my memory in function here for what items I need and when, if you get what I'm saying. Because some elements are similar, like I said, but the order at which I'm actually ploughing through this mansion is different. Very different, actually. So, it's going to be a bit weird, at least. I wonder if she goes to the next place, if they're any different at all. Well, I guess we'll find out. No point in talking about it, really, but, yeah, talking about new games, like I said, Resident Evil, the new remake, I really want to play it on its release. I do really want to play it on its release. I've heard a lot of people have actually managed to get a copy of it before it's even been released in this country, which is a bit dodgy, but, another game I'm really looking forward to playing at some point is Resident Evil Revelations. I've just ordered that the other day, actually. Now, from what I recall, I might be completely wrong here, but you can actually run past all these zombies. Oh, shit. Providing they don't barf on you like that. Hopefully I'm not poisoned. I don't think you can get poisoned this early on in the game. There's two doors here. Can I actually open either of these? Is there any point in opening these? Isn't this the one with the keypad that I never, ever figured out what it does? Yeah. I never figured out what that did in my Chris playthrough. Like, I remember it, but I don't remember it doing anything. I probably need to heal myself, to be honest. After being vomited on twice and bitten, you know. Oh yeah, definitely do. Gosh, well, I'll combine these two together and yes, wow, it actually questions and use that, so that'll pop me back on fine there. Any zombies around here? There's one here. I'll take him out with a shotgun blast. And there's one there as well, right. Well, I'm not going to take any risks because I don't want to use any health items. We've got plenty of bullets at the moment. Not many shotgun shells left, but hey-ho. We'll be alright. Oh god, this music is gorgeous. Wow, look at that. Look at how bad that... It's like, it's rendered, for some reason, the top of it's going to be animated and then the rest of it isn't. I'm talking about the inventory stash there. So look at it, it's really pixelated at the bottom and then it isn't for the rest of it. Vitamins and serums. It seems like some of them are standing out, but I can't actually pick them up at all. Ink ribbon. Are you suggesting something? Of course you are, right. I will use an ink ribbon. I think it would be wise to actually, get my inventory sorted just in case I do die and give up at this point, which I really doubt is going to happen, but there's a chance. I'll put the shotgun away for now. May as well get rid of those. I'll keep the grenade launcher with me. Reload the pistol. May as well keep the remainder of the shells on me. And I'm carrying around this key. I don't have a clue what it's for, if I'm being honest. Could be like miles from now that you have to use it, but I think this is going to be my inventory for now, so I'll reload the gun, Not much point in me carrying around 4 bullets, is there? Let's drop it off. We'll drop it off. Get rid of it. Though that said, they might come in handy. Okay, fuck it. Right. Being indecisive now. Not gonna be like my old Let's Plays where I just pondered things for ages, like putting them back in the inventory, taking them out again, putting them back, taking them out. Oh my god. So there we go, first save. The M room. I'm guessing that's medical room. I don't know.